And I want to tell you the story of it, because there's an interesting story that goes along with it. Basically, my I took a year off and went traveling, which was fun. And I was traveling around the world, seeing lots of things and meeting lots of weird things. And my grandmother, who actually inspired the very first line of Thinking Out Loud, when your legs don't work like they used to before. She's always had health problems, always had health problems. And she got very sick. And my mum called me and said, you need to come back from traveling because she might pass away quite soon. So, and I was all kind of teed up to go and make my records elsewhere. So what I did instead is I brought everyone to me, and I made my album near where my gran was in hospital, and I got to visit her almost every single day, and they gave her a week, and 6 months later she was still there. She's a fighter. And you know, it was one of these weird things, because my brother is a classical composer, right? And me and him have zero in common apart from the love that we share for each other. And she said, "Oh, wouldn't it be nice if you two worked together?" And we were both kind of like, how? And so when you listen to the song Perfect, all those beautiful string arrangements, that's my brother. We had our first UK number one together, which was quite cool. So that happened because of my grandmother, and we actually got to record that Abbey Road Studios and play it to her in the hospital bed before she passed away, which was a really, really beautiful moment. So anyway, as I said, I was making the record and I was traveling sort of back and forth from the hospital, and then one day she passed away. And it's one of those things where she'd lived such an amazing life, and you know, had got to say goodbye to everyone that she needed to say goodbye to, and it was like almost the perfect way to do it, but it didn't stop people being upset, especially my mum. And when I get upset or happy or anything, I write a song. So I wrote this song from my mum's perspective of how she felt, and it's called Supermarket Flowers. I took the supermarket flowers from the windowsill. I threw the day-old tea from the cup. Packed up the photo albums Matthew had made, memories of a life that's been loved. I took the Gail Wilson cards and stuffed animals. I threw the old ginger beer down the sink. Dad always told me, "Don't you cry when you're down," but Mom, there's a tear every time that I blink. Oh, I'm in pieces, it's tearing me up, but I know a heart that's broke is a heart that's been loved. So I'll sing hallelujah. You are an angel in the shape of my mom. When I fell down, you'd be there holding me up. Spread your wings as you go. When God takes you back, he'll say hallelujah, you're home. Fluff the pillows, the beds, and stack the chairs up. Folded your nightgowns neatly in a case. John said he'd drive and put his hand on my cheek, wiped a tear from the side of my face. And I hope that I see the world as you did, 'cause I know a life with love is a life that's been lived. So you were an angel in the shape of my mom. When I fell down, you'd be there holding me up. Spread your wings as you go. When God takes you back, he'll say hallelujah, you're home. Hallelujah. You were an angel in the shape of my mom. You got to see the person I am become. Spread your wings, and I know that when God took you back, he said, hallelujah, you're home.